السلام عليكم. Hi, grade 4. Today, inshallah, we will complete our lessons about making circuits. This is lesson 3. So, the first point today, look at these following figures and answer the following. Can you see this simple electric circuit? It consists of what? One lamp and one battery. One lamp and one battery. And this simple electric circuit consists of two lamps and one battery. So, what do you think? Which one, which lamp is here will be more brighter? This one or this one? Okay, what do you think? Of course, this one will be more brighter. Why? Because here one battery with one lamp, but here we have two lamps and one battery. So the electricity inside this battery will move or flows through the wire to two batteries, not only one battery. Okay, so do you think we can add more lamps to a circuit? Yes, we can. We can add more lamps, two or three or four. Where will you put lamps? Anywhere in the circuit. We can put it anywhere in the circuit. What do you predict? Predict means what? Think. What do you think will happen when you add more lamps? What will happen, you girls? The lamps will be the same bright or will be less brighter? Will be less brighter because we have one battery with two lamps. What can we do to make the lamps brighter? What can we do to these lamps to make them more brighter or like this lamp? So we will add more batteries to the circuit. We will add more batteries, not only one, but we will add more batteries to the circuit. Okay. What will happen if we make a circuit with three batteries and three lamps like the following figure? Here, sorry, this is four, not three lamps. We have here four lamps and three batteries. What will happen? The lamps stayed what? Bright. The lamps stayed bright. If we have three lamps, not four. What will happen? The lamps stayed bright. Three lamps with three batteries. What will happen here when we change the position of the batteries and lamps of the circuit like the following figures? Can you see this? Here we have three batteries and three lamps. And here also we have three batteries and three lamps. But we change the position of them. We change the position of batteries here and lamps here. We change the position. What is the meaning of position? The places of the batteries and lamps in the two electric circuits. What will happen? The brightness of the lamps doesn't change. The brightness of the lamps doesn't change when we change the positions of the lamps or batteries. We can use electricity from two sources now. Batteries or mains electricity. You remember this? You take this in grade 2. So we can use electricity from two sources, maybe batteries or mains electricity. Okay, why do we use batteries in school investigations? If we wanted to do any experiment with electricity, we use batteries. We don't use mains electricity. Why, girls? Because what? Batteries have what? Have much lower voltage. What is the meaning of voltage? Force. Lower force of electricity or lower electricity. So voltage means what? Electricity. So the batteries have lower electricity than the mains electricity. You remember mains electricity? Like socket and plug? Okay, so why do we use batteries in our experiments, in our school investigations, or in science lab experiments? Why? Because batteries have much lower voltage than mains electricity. Lower voltage means what? Lower force of electricity. So this will be more safe and less dangerous. More safe for you and less dangerous. Okay, concentrate now to these important notes. Number one, the force of electricity in a circuit is measured in volts. What is the meaning of volts? Do you know when we want to measure length of something, which unit we use? Do you say the length of a pencil, for example, is 5 kilograms or 5 centimeters? You say that the length of pencil is 5 centimeters. So you use centimeters for the length or meters for the length. And the mass, if you wanted to measure mass, you use which unit? You say what? The mass of the of these apples, for example, is 5 kilograms. So we use kilograms or grams for measuring mass. And you remember force or weight from grade 3, we use which unit? We use Newton unit. So here also, the force of electricity, we use volt to measure it. Can you say the force of electricity is 5 kilograms or 5 centimeters or 5 newtons? No. So we use the volts or the unit volt for measuring what? The force of electricity. In most countries, the mains electricity has a voltage between, voltage means what? Force of electricity. In most countries, the mains electricity has force of electricity between 220 and 240 volts. That comes from the power stations. You remember the electricity power stations? So the electricity which comes from the power stations, the voltage of it between 220 volts and 220 and 240 volts, okay? Small things like torches, you know torch? You know torches? Okay, and toys need low electricity. So they use batteries. If we use torch to light anything or use toys to play, we need low electricity, not much electricity. So we use what? We use batteries, not mains electricity. The batteries here has what? Have what? 1.5 volt or 3 volts or 9 volts, not 220 or 240 volts. But here, large things like fridges, like televisions, like computers, like any devices, like vacuum, like washing machine, they need what? A lot of electricity, so we can't use batteries for them. So we use what? Mains electricity, which volt is between what? 110 or 220 volts or 240 volts, okay? But not 1.5 or 3 or 9. This is so lower electricity, so low voltage, okay? Number 5, the last point today, inshallah. Mains electricity is very dangerous. Why, girls? Why it is very dangerous? Because what? It can flow through our bodies easily, okay? If la qadra Allah, any mains electricity come to your body, it can flow through your body easily. So this human will have electric shock and may be killed, okay? If you can't understand any point, please send message to me. Thank you, girls, for listening to me.